Hi everybody, welcome to ThaiFact.com. Well, today is Coronation Day here in Bangkok, and that is a celebration of His Majesty the King's coronation to the throne of Thailand. It's a national holiday and everyone takes the day off to give praise and thanks to what the King has done for the country. Today is also an interesting day in the ongoing political protests in that a few days ago, the government offered a roadmap to peace, as they called it. They offered to hold elections, which is what the Reds have wanted all along. They want new elections. So the government has offered to hold elections on November 14th. And they've made some of these offers before, but the Reds have always declined them because they've always demanded elections to be held immediately. The Reds seem to be unwilling to compromise at all on that. So the government offered November 15th. And interestingly, the Reds have accepted it on principle. Why this sudden change of heart from the Red Movement is not entirely sure. They've suffered a few PR blunders in the past few days. A few days ago, they invaded the Chulalongkorn Hospital, claiming that they saw government snipers inside. And it was a huge PR disaster for them because the hospital had to wheel out the patients, and there's press at every single one of these events. Wherever the Reds go, there's press now. So it really doesn't look good for your cause when the hospital, which is supposed to be neutral, is having to wheel out patients because you're wandering inside looking for snipers. And I've kind of noticed this trend amongst the Reds since April 10th is that they seem willing to do anything to accomplish their goal, and they always blame it on these snipers. Everyone I've talked to, when I kind of question them about why they're doing this, why they're doing that, their response is always, oh, there's some snipers over there, there's some snipers over here. So, and the same thing, they said that there were snipers in the hospital, so that's when they invaded it. So, a huge PR blunder for them that looked really bad, angered a lot of people in Bangkok. And so I suspect that that might be one of the reasons why the Reds have softened their stance a little bit and accepted this government offer of peace, of holding elections on November 14th. I've been told that secretly the government and the Red Party have been in negotiations since April 10th. Just publicly they can't, tell that, but I've been told in secret that they have been. So this may have been a culmination of the past few weeks of negotiation, so both sides can appear to save face. The government makes an offer, the Reds publicly decline it, but make a bit of an agree in principle, but with some conditions. So it'll kind of go back and forth a little bit, but the general feeling in the city seems to be that this is moving towards a conclusion. What's really great for a lot of people who have to commute in Bangkok is the BTS line has finally opened up to regular hours again. So I know a lot of taxi drivers might not be too happy with that, but a lot of commuters are happy that the BTS is running normal hours again. So it looks like we're headed towards a conclusion. The Reds have said that they are going to stay in the downtown core until the government sets a date for the dissolution of parliament. So hopefully the government announces that soon. And once they do, the Reds have said that they will leave. There's a few other technical details that have to be worked out. The Reds are claiming that if the leadership of the Red Movement faces prosecution, they also want the leadership of the Yellow Movement that closed the airport to face prosecution as well. That might be a little bit difficult because the leaders of the Yellows who closed the airport now actually work for the government. So there's a few little nitty-gritties that have to be worked out. But the general feeling it seems to be is that this is an agreement that both sides can agree on and will work towards ending this within the next few weeks, apparently. There's a few things that are happening that are kind of pushing the Reds to finish up here. One is that the school season starts, I think it's on May 17th. So many of them that with kids here, if they want their kids to go to school, they got to go back to the east side and put their kids in school. The other is that the rainy season is starting soon. And for many of them, the rainy season is when they have to plant their crops, for their rice crops. So if they don't plant now, they can't harvest it later on. So many of them are eyeing the weather and looking at heading home to start planting their crops. So within the next few weeks, there's a bit of a time frame on the Red Movement. So I think that the combination of the disaster with the hospital is perhaps led the Red Movement to soften their stance of the no compromise to this agreement from the government. I mean, many other parts of the city have returned to normal. The Saffron Panfrao Democracy Monument, where they had the deadliest clash yet, is returned to normal. Traffic there is normal. Looks like these protests might be resolved in the next few weeks. everyone's just kind of waiting and hoping that no one rocks the boat, because I'm sure everybody, I think, really wants these protests to finish up. I'm sure many members of the Red, the crowd here today is much, much thinner than it has been in the last few weeks. I think a lot of them have gone home. The government has claimed that they're going to set up barricades around here to block supplies coming in. So I think the Reds are really starting to see the writing on the wall, and that their movement is dwindling in numbers and their strength is dwindling as well. So I think both sides, the government and the Red side, really want an end to this as quickly and as peacefully as they can, that allows both sides to save face. And so hopefully that happens within the next few weeks. Whatever happens, I'll try to keep you updated. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.